What do critics of CRT get wrong? They get almost all of this willfully wrong. They don't want to come to acknowledge that there are different cultures and different traditions, different languages, different religions that can shape and inform and inspire them to find new answers in their lives, to shape new public policy. The core of what I do with that is by pointing back to indigenous societies, pre-modern indigenous societies, that I've heard public commentators refer to as existing from the Stone Age, that they dismiss and demean indigenous societies around the world. And as an outgrowth of Afrofuturism, where we see that the perception of Africa over time was very similar, that there was no possible way there could be civilizations on the African continent, we're in a moment in the 21st century where we must embrace these societies that we've written out of history, that we've erased from the record. And that's what the critics get wrong. They need to turn away from banning resources and silencing people from public participation. And actually, the people that they instinctively resist are the most important people for them to listen to. The book is titled Illmatic Consequences, based on Nas's 1994 Illmatic. Nas's creativity shows that there are people who are underestimated, are discounted, aren't taken seriously. And in doing so, in dismissing them, we dismantle what it is to consider ourselves free. When we ignore the ability of people who are cast aside to give back, to lift us in ways that we don't expect, that is exactly what the propaganda campaign against critical race theory tries to do. It tries to standardize. It tries to silence. It moves us to a place where we can't benefit from all of the art and all of the knowledge that we generate from all sources. I have at the center of the book a really priceless gift by Stacey Robinson. Stacey Robinson's work has defined what we consider the Afrofuturist aesthetic. How do we look at the world through a different lens? And so a few years ago, he was at Harvard University as a Nasir Jones Fellow. Stacey Robinson's chapter focuses on seeing Nas's career through a graphic arts lens. He takes a number of portraits, but he then interprets them into what I would describe as dreamscapes, where the impact of the art then takes on the voice that Nas presents on his albums. It's a tangible experience to see a piece by Stacey Robinson. You come away from it transformed. Nothing stays in a steady state, it overheats and melts. It only feeds itself, the system. The inspiration they take from the text should start with the idea that they have an accurate understanding of critical race theory and how it is so good for every reader to learn more about themselves and to learn more about their world. Beyond that, I hope they'll also get to the place that they can reflect on the media they consume and resist the disinformation that they find, to not get swept away by the propaganda that's so prevalent. And finally, I want them to have a set of solutions that they can actually use to make for better families, better communities, healthier lives for all of us.